with our background, like, you know, Northeast and Mizoram, like, we're so passionate about music and art, and I always wanted to do that. First, my mom cried a lot,
oh,
to be honest. She'd call me and say, what are you doing?
You went abroad to study,
yeah,
and now you're dropping out.
Yeah, exactly. She's like, you're in your third year, just finish. Even if you want,
yeah,
do it later. But I think because of dance, it made, like I said, it gave me clarity, like something to work toward, something I was interested in. Like, it gave me a lot of peace inside. Just, I was okay with what was happening. And so when I would call on the phone also, my relationship with my mom also started changing, like, for the better.
Okay.
Like, I was more positive, like, my outlook was more positive. Because when you're happy, you start finding
yeah,
like, better connections,
yeah,
with people, with ideas. So she started seeing that change. So she's like, it's okay, you go do that.
It's very commercial, it's mainstream. Like, I joined a hip-hop class before I danced with Joshua. It's so much more about the choreography, but with Josh, it's about how much exploration you can do with the body.
There's this urban culture going with, like,
BMX.
Yeah, BMX,
skate.
People are skating, doing parkour. There's this
very similar.
Urban.
Yeah.
This urban culture is growing. It's more going that way for now,
yeah,
just because of what's there, what's readily available, what
yeah,
the youth is interested in is right now that.
I think you can give credit for learning so much given the little
resources.
My sister also is a musician, so when I was little, and she's older than me, so, you know, when I was little, I was like, I want to do that, you know, and she, so I actually started on violin, because
oh,
she was a violinist, but I hated it and never wanted to practice, it's like, okay. So yeah, after a while, I was like, I don't want to play violin, and I don't quite know why, but I just knew I wanted to play the cello.
Oh.
I said, no, I don't want to play the violin anymore, and then I think my mom was like, all right, you can stop, and then I was like, but I want to play this other instrument. So I was around 9 when
wow,
I started playing cello. I'm sure if you ask the people I work with, I'll be able to say. I definitely, I was watching a video from, like, the first time, that first trip I came to
uh-huh,
Ipoh, and I got to sit with Manka and Mangsana, and they were trying to teach me a folk song. And I was sitting and I was struggling so hard to try to get this folk song because the rhythm is so different. You know,
huh,
it just takes some time to feel the rhythm.
Huh.
But it's very, you know, everyone who grew up here would immediately
be able to get it.
And
yeah,
I was watching this video and listening to the recording again of, like, me trying to learn this song and it being hours. You know, like, I think they were working with me for, like, an hour with this song. But they were so patient. And it's like, keep going. They would keep singing it with me, and I remember even in the moment being really embarrassed. I'm like, how can I not get this?
We've only performed it once, I think.
Yeah.
Like, we haven't been able to, or we haven't planned an event deliberately for the show.
Okay.
We find the only time we performed was in a celebration of the statehood of Mizoram.
Uh-huh.
It was a function that was already planned. It wasn't exactly dedicated for the show, so it was like an amorphous group. I don't know.
Mm-hmm.
Like, there were kids watching, there were parents watching. If you weren't even interested, you had to watch the show. No, because you were finding space to perform the case, so it's like
you had to watch.
Yeah. Like, if it was a group of similar interests who came
uh-huh,
for the show, then the result would have been different. Like the feedback would have been different. Like from that group, everyone was like, "Oh, good performance." It's more about the performance than what the piece is about.
Because contemporary in any field, not just dance, is very young in Israel. Even for visual arts, like, you know, people still want to see just the old painting, just the beautiful scenery, and like all these young artists, they're like, they just don't have an audience. It's like a lot of it is educating still. But having said that, there's always mixed reactions. Like not with this one, because this project, we've only been working on it since January, but not even the full year, like January, and then we had to take a pause because he started college again. Then we picked it back up in May and like seeing how it goes.
I had always been really interested in coming back to the Northeast because I had been to Kohima when I first came to India in 2012 with a band, actually. We were in the Hornbill Rock Festival.
Okay.
But I didn't get to see much, and I was so interested. It was my first exposure to just the how different the Northeast was. And so I had the chance to come back there with our other collaborator who was doing her PhD research on actually the peace talks in Kohima in the 60s. One of our guides had to come to Imphal for work, and I had never heard it. I didn't know that it was so close, and you know, it was like, oh, it's only 2 hours on a bus ride. You know, we have to go. And you know, we were really interested at that point in connecting with different artists and just seeing what the different scenes were in the Northeast, so that we could continue. You could come back later and continue to do more collaborating. So that's how I first ended up here, and it was only 3.5 days, I think, but it was an incredibly rich. It felt like an entire year in terms of, you know, the amount of people we met and the generosity and everything that we were receiving in terms of just knowledge and people staying up all night talking to us about history of Imphal and arts, and so it was really incredible time. And I also saw a lot of similarity with my own background and Native Hawaiian history and culture, and there's just this resonance with the arts community. There's such a diverse arts community, from like folk traditional to very experimental work, and that range and that richness, I think, really interested me, along with the kind of parallels of community and history. So then I knew I had to come back, and so then since then it's been just this momentum of getting back here and getting to do more work.
So I think be curious, share, like let it grow together, and build a community. And it's so rich here. Like we've met so many really talented people, very passionate people, not just as performers or artists, but as people who want to support. They're also very committed and passionate about supporting the growth of the arts here. So it's really nice to see that. So just continue to work together and be curious.
And Sojit has been such an amazing person in contact here. Just, you know, now we all are connected. You know, just it's amazing to be here and then get to meet all of the artists who are a hub, like contemporary artists who can come through this one space. So, you know, really, like, seek out those other communities, like the other, where the conversation is, even if it's small, even if it's just a few people.